Good afternoon. My name is Jonathan Swartz, and I'm the artistic director for Madeline Island Chamber Music. Now, earlier this morning, we had a concert that featured half of the students studying in our program. And this afternoon, we are going to get to hear the other half of our students perform. Now, one of the things that I heard a lot from those of you in attendance earlier this morning was how amazed you were to learn that our students essentially started working and studying this repertoire together just on Monday. And I want to take a moment to acknowledge our faculty who have been working with our students all week long. They include violinist formerly of the Cecilia String Quartet and currently at the Royal Conservatory of Music in Toronto, Min Jung Ko. Violists formerly of the Harlem and Fine Arts Quartets and currently at the University of Montreal, Juan Miguel Hernandez. Cellist from the Minnesota Orchestra, Pitt Neri Shin. And members of the Harlem Quartet, violinist Ilmar Gavilan, violist Jaime Amador, and cellist Felix Umansky. Now I encourage you to join us next week when we will feature two more young artist programs, as well as a concert featuring the Jupiter String Quartet. And now for the music, thank you for being here, and please join me in welcoming our first group to the stage.
Hello, everybody. Today we're going to play Debussy String Quartet in G minor, second and third movement. So Debussy was inspired by French composer called César Franck. I hope you guys know. So he used a lot of Franck's technique and style of music. For example, Debussy uses this one main theme from first movement into this second movement. And not only he uses that, but he also make a variation of it quite a few times to make this second movement special and unique. And in the third movement, it's gonna feature a beautiful melody spread across the parts. And then these two lower voices gonna make a beautiful harmonies, complex harmonies to make this tension and then special moments. And yeah, we had so much fun working on these two movements together, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Today we are going to be performing the two inner movements of Mendelssohn's String Quartet, Opus 44, Number 3. The first that we are going to be playing is a lively and quite dramatic scherzo, which is then going to be contrasted by a almost painfully beautiful slow adagio movement. So we've had a lot of fun working on these two very different movements, and we really hope that you enjoy them. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. The piece that we're going to play for you is by a friend of ours. His name is Carlos Simon, and we actually had the pleasure to go to the University of Michigan with him. He composed this piece in 2019 and revised it in 2020, and it's titled Warmth of Other Suns. It's based on the book by the same name by Isabel Wilkerson, and it tells the story of three families that migrate from the south to the north during the Great Migration. And the first movement is called Rays of Light, and you will hear harmonics, which I think it's maybe the most beautiful way and the most, the best way to represent rays of light in music, in my opinion. And the second movement is called Flight, and you are going to feel the anxiety that these people are feeling as they are both running and also being chased in their journey. And the last movement is called Settle, and based on the harmonies at the end, just draw your own conclusions. Thank you so much. This is Warmth of Other Suns.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello. Today we'll be playing the inner movements of Mendelssohn's second quartet, Opus 13 in A minor. The first movement we'll be playing starts off with an adagio, which features a lively sound, also lyrical melodies throughout every instrument. Then is contrasted by a more intense animato, which has the melodies featured in the adagio section. Then we'll be playing the third movement, which is a more mischievous sound, very reminiscent of what Mendelssohn is most famous for, his scherzo movements. The entire work is inspired by Mendelssohn at the age of 18, his first true love and heartbreak. We've loved playing this piece and rehearsing it, and hope you guys enjoy it.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. I just want to make a quick announcement. There's a slight program change. We'll be playing the scherzo from Beethoven's string trio first, and then the second movement of Dagnani's trio. The scherzo movement is filled with, you know, vitality, contagious energy, and rhythmic bite. And the second movement of Dagnani's romance is has a very lyrical and beautiful folk-like melody, along with a very passionate outburst in the middle. Hope you guys enjoy. Thank you.
Everyone, thank you so much for coming today. It's an honor to play for you and share the stage with such incredible musicians. Everyone did so amazing today. Today, we will be playing the fourth and fifth movements of Hindemith's Fourth String Quartet. This piece was written in 1921, pretty directly following World War I, in which Hindemith himself served on the front lines for a period of time. So we definitely found like a lot of the sorrow and pain and heaviness that accompanies the war, but also there's no shortage of sarcasm and levity and laughing in the face of what happened. Hindemith was an avid chamber musician, playing in several ensembles and quartets throughout his life, including founding one while he was serving the army. Most notably, however, he founded the Amar Quartet in 1921, which is the same year that this piece was written. And they even made a recording of this a couple of years later. Hindemith was the violist of this quartet, and his cousin Rudolf Hindemith was the cellist. So naturally, the fourth movement is a dramatic and virtuosic viola and cello concerto. The fifth movement kind of crashes into a fugal, dance-like, almost goofy rondo, and yeah, kind of ends a little strangely, but we have a lot of fun with it. So thank you so much for coming, and we really hope you enjoyed Hindemith's fourth quartet. Thank you.
Thank you.